Well, it's good to be here in a church where Teen Challenge feels at home, and we thank you for that. You know, God is doing great things at Memphis Teen Challenge. Hallelujah. Amen. That's a good time for an amen, right at the beginning. This last year, we purchased a brand new 26,000 square foot building to move our thrift store in, and we are on the corner of Cleveland and Madison. If you're in Midtown or downtown, stop by and see us. Come into the thrift store, and our guys will be glad to wash your car. We just got back from a missions trip, and we've got another one planned for the beginning of next year. We have two men graduating next month from Teen Challenge. We've got our big annual banquet coming up. God is doing great things at Memphis Teen Challenge. Now, when we talk about growth and we talk about God doing exciting things at Teen Challenge, it means one thing. It means a life that the devil meant to destroy with drugs and alcohol and addiction is being given a second chance by the grace of God, and a life is being saved. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. We don't build churches, we don't grow ministries to glorify individuals or institutions or denominations. We do it to glorify God. And we know that every dollar that comes into Memphis Teen Challenge, every bed that we add to our campus, every piece of brick we lay down means another life that is going to be saved to the glory of God. And that's why we do the work that we do. I'm going to invite our men that are going to share in a human video. I'm going to invite you to come up and take your place if you would. That work could not happen without the partnership of churches like Collierville First Assembly. Amen? Without your partnership, we are not able to do the work that we do. Now, I'm thankful these guys are able to join you every month for a service, and they're able to be fed. And this morning, we want to be able to give back and encourage you and share about what God is doing in the life of men at Memphis Teen Challenge. We're going to begin with a human video. This is our missions team that we just got back. And they're going to share a human video, and then I'll come back up.
Thank you.
Amen. Brother Alex, you can stay right up. You're the last one off stage, so you're going to give your testimony, brother. Share with these people a little bit about your life, what brought you to Teen Challenge, and what God is doing in your life.
All right. He got me this time. I had no idea. I guess it's better when you don't know, when you don't have to practice for what you say, because if the Holy Spirit's in you, He just speaks through you. So I'm 42 years old. I came here back in January. I'm a binge drinker, vodka, anything with a blue top on it. I would go a year at a time, maybe 6 months at a time with no drinking, and then I would go on a binge. It was usually when things were going good in my life. It wasn't when I was struggling. If I got a new job, if I was spending time with my family, if I got a promotion, when things were good, I would sabotage myself. I didn't feel like I deserved any of the things that God was giving me. And the reason I felt that way is because I didn't have a relationship with God. I didn't know God. I didn't know Jesus. I drove myself to Teen Challenge from the detox department at North Mississippi Medical Center on January 3rd of this year. And then I surrendered, accepted Jesus Christ as my Savior. And on May 22nd, I was baptized at First Assembly in Memphis. And the things that are happening in my life, the healing that's going on in my life is unbelievable. My family, who didn't want anything to do with me, wouldn't let me come home and stay there on pass, didn't want to talk to me. My own son, who I didn't talk to or even hear from or see since Christmas of last year, he came yesterday. And I spent time with him on pass. The healing that's going on in my family is going on because I was removed from that situation. Once I was taken away and God was able to do his work without me interrupting it, putting my hands all over it and destroying it, things got better. And they continue to get better. I'm going to go to the Hope House, hopefully in October, God willing. And then I'll transition back into the real world as a child of God. So I can't wait. Thank Teen Challenge, all the staff. Thank you guys here at the church, all the churches we go to. God bless you. Thank you.
Stay up here, brother. Stay up here if you would. You know, Brother Alex mentioned the Hope House. Some of us in this congregation are familiar with that, our reentry facility we built a couple years ago. And this church was a key supporter for that building going up. We are seeing the fruit of it happen every single day. And we're believing, Brother Alex, that God's going to do great work in your life. And we're believing that God's going to use you to minister to other people. Amen? Would you join me and let's pray for Brother Alex this morning. Let's pray over this life. Lord, I thank you for Alex. I thank you for his testimony. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus, that addiction, Lord, that bottle, Lord God, that stronghold over his life, Lord, let it be broken once and forevermore by the power of the blood of Jesus. Lord, that he would never go back to a drink, Lord, but that he would experience true freedom in your grace. Lord, you've got a great calling on his life, and I pray in the name of Jesus, let him see it. And Lord, let him run towards it. Use his testimony and the pain that he's gone through to impact someone else's life for the glory of God. We give you praise and thanks in your strong name. Amen. Amen. God bless you, Brother Alex. Well, I don't know if you know this, but the Apostle Paul was a Teen Challenge graduate. Did you know that? The Apostle Paul, whose claim to fame before he met Christ, was a persecutor and a killer of Christians. And yet, on the road to Damascus, God got a hold of him and knocked him off his high horse. Anybody ever had that happen to you? I have. God gets my attention, knocks me off my horse. He fell to the ground and he had an encounter with the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Some of us know that as a jailhouse experience. Amen? We hit our rock bottom and the only place we can look up is up, and we cry out to Jesus and say, Jesus, save me from where I am. And I thank God that no matter how many steps, Teen Challenge, Collierville, that we walk away from God, it is only one step back to him. I thank God you didn't deserve it, but he heard you in that moment of rock bottom, and he reached down and he rescued you. Amen, Amen, Teen Challenge. And then Paul, the Bible says, disappeared for a year. Does that sound familiar, Teen Challenge? I told you he was a Teen Challenge graduate. Disappeared for a year so that he could be discipled and learn what it means to be a follower of Jesus Christ, to get all of that garbage out of his life so that he could live the kind of life that God had created him to live. And when he emerged out of that isolation, God used him to do incredible things for the glory of God. I know this church prays for Teen Challenge. I know this church believes in Teen Challenge. Would you continue to do so? Would you continue to lift these men up in prayer and believe that God is going to use them to do great things for the glory of God? Yeah. Amen? Yeah. It's good to see my friend, Brother Michael. Where's Brother Wilson at? Did he leave? Isn't that great timing?
He was here.
I heard about a preacher who, he had somebody in his church he was upset at, and he wrote this great sermon, spent all week. He was going to zing him with that sermon, and he got up there on Sunday morning, he was ready to deliver it, and he looked out in the seat they were in, and they were gone. Sometimes that happens in church. But I thank God for Brother Michael Wilson. A testimony to what God can do when we persevere. Will you be praying for these guys? Pray for them. God has great plans in store for their life. God wants to do great things through these men. As he emerged from that wilderness, God used Paul to do great things for the glory of God. 1 Corinthians, Paul writes a letter to the church in Corinth that's having all kinds of trouble. And I love what Paul says. Remember, here's a Teen Challenge graduate. He didn't learn this in a Bible school. He experienced it in life. And he says this, the message of the cross is what? Foolishness to those who are perishing. But for those of us that have been saved in that moment when we didn't deserve it, and like me at times, I have kicked against God and said, God, leave me alone in this moment of my life. And yet God didn't answer that prayer. And he rescued me out of my own sin and my own rebellion. Even those people, it is our power for living. That's a good time for an amen. Amen. Paul says, where is the wise man? Where's the scholar? Where's the philosopher of this age? Has God not made foolish the wisdom of the world? Now, Teen Challenge, we call that faith. Here's how faith works. Faith is when our belief in God exceeds our understanding. A young man comes into Teen Challenge day one, strung out on meth. Family's given up on them. They come in with a bag over their shoulder, the only possession that they have. They have bounced in and out of jails and prisons and rehabs. And the world says, we can't explain how this person can be saved. People have given up on them. But God is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above anything we can ask, think, hope, or explain. Faith is when our expectation exceeds our understanding. God, I don't know how you're going to rescue this man, but God, my belief is in you and not in what the world says. Amen. Somebody this morning, that doctor has looked across that table at you and said, there's no hope, there's no cure. Faith says, God, I don't know how you're going to heal, but my belief in you will exceed my ability to explain it. Amen. It's good preaching. I don't know how I'm going to pay my bills this month. God, I look at my checks or my bills and I look at my bank account and the two just don't match. God, my belief in you is going to exceed my ability to explain it. Would you claim that this morning? Would you believe that? Somebody in this room, you're facing something. You can't explain your way out of it. Would you turn your eyes to the problem solver and get your eyes off your problem? Where's the wise man? Where's the scholar? Where's the philosopher? God has made foolish the wisdom of this age. That's faith. Amen? Brother Thibodeau, I'm going to ask you if you'd come up, and I want you to share. You are a picture of faith. Amen? Would you share what God has done in your life and how he's brought you to where you are today?
Yeah. Hey, everybody. My name is Jared. I'm from Louisiana, and I'm 26 years old. I just want to give glory to God for a couple things first. I'm 7 months clean and sober. Yeah. That's awesome. I'm 7 months without cursing. I mean, I'm changing my behavior radically. It's been a long 7 months, but it's been the best 7 months of my life so far. And I give glory to God about that. I was pretty much addicted to anything that took me out of the reality of what my life really was. And I found out that all of it was just a Band-Aid. And I finally found the God who can heal the actual wound underneath the Band-Aid. Amen? My life's changing so much. I want to go further after Teen Challenge. I want to go to Bible school, and I want to be a preacher one day. I'm trying to get over my public speaking. It's kind of hard for me, but one day I want to be up here. I'm telling y'all, the world mixes up your thoughts and your emotions and tells you to go this way, and God's over there saying it's this way. And I just thank God so much for providing me a path, a boat, a lifeboat to go into to show me the proper way to live. And that's Teen Challenge from my respect. So keep believing in us and keep believing that God will do powerful things. It's awesome, y'all. I love who I am and I love God. Amen.
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 You know, you said one day you're going to be up here. You realize you're up here right now.
Yeah, it's weird.
Amen?
Amen.
Now, if we would have walked into your life a year ago, people would have turned their back and said, he's hopeless. We can't explain how God brought you to where you are today. We can't explain how God has put a burden on your heart to go into ministry. However, my belief in God supersedes any explanation anyone else can give, because I've seen it happen over and over and over again.
Amen.
You're a living testimony to that. Can we pray for Brother Jared this morning? Lord, we thank you for this testimony, Lord God, a life saved and transformed by the power and the grace of Jesus Christ. And Lord, you have took what the devil meant for evil, a life that has been bound up by sin and addiction. And Lord, you have unwound all of those knots in his life, Lord, and you have set him on the right path. And Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus, guard him. Give him wisdom, Lord God. Lord, that he would keep his eyes fixed on the prize, not graduation from Teen Challenge, not standing behind a pulpit, Lord God, but that prize of being able to stand one day in glory and you look down and say, well done, my good and faithful servant. Keep his eyes on that prize, not behind, but ahead. And we give you thanks and praise in the strong name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Would you give Brother Jared a round of applause? It's the Apostle Paul in 2016. Amen? I love it. Listen to what Paul says. Jews demand miraculous signs. Greeks look for wisdom. Hey, at Teen Challenge, we see miraculous signs every single week. I thank God for that. We see the book of, some people say Book of Acts happened 2,000 years ago. No, it's happening at 33 North Cleveland every single day. Miracles. If your faith is on low, come down to Teen Challenge for one day and hang around these guys. Miracles happening through the glory of God. Greeks look for wisdom. Can I give a word of encouragement to this church? You have one of the great preachers in Tennessee every single week on this pulpit. Amen. Now, I've been to a lot of churches. I went to one church, the pastor threw some duct tape to his deacon, this is a true story, and had him wrap up the handles to the door so nobody could get out. Now, if he spent a little more time during the week preparing his sermon and praying through it, he wouldn't need any duct tape if he preached the word of God with conviction. We don't need duct tape here. You are blessed beyond measure to have somebody that shares the wisdom of God with power and authority and clarity week after week after week. Don't take that for granted. Amen. However, despite the miracles that take place at Teen Challenge, despite the wisdom that we hear from our pulpit, listen to what Paul says. The Jews demand miraculous signs. The Greeks look for wisdom, but we preach Christ crucified. I am under no illusion. Teen Challenge does not work because of a handsome executive director. It does not work because of great curriculum. It does not work because of beds and buildings and food. It works because the power of Jesus Christ intervenes in a life and has the final word. And the same thing is true with this church. In spite of great preaching, this church will thrive when we are dependent on Jesus and Jesus alone. Teen Challenge, we walk into the doors of Teen Challenge the first day. And we're looking for hope. We've got a sign outside that says there's hope. And if you come into my office, I will tell you that there is no hope for your life. No hope. Save in the blood of Jesus Christ. You can excel in every aspect of our program. You can become a dorm monitor and a student leader. You can go through the Hope House and have the best exit plan in the world. But without Jesus Christ at the center of your life, there is no hope. Yeah. Anchor yourself to that this morning. Church, anchor yourself. You can have the best worship team and the most beautiful lights, and you can have smoke coming up, and you can have a great children's program. You can have youth pastors that can dazzle the entire city, but without Jesus Christ, there is no hope. Amen. Might as well close the doors. This is a stumbling block. The world wants glitz and glamour. The world wants power and possession. It's a stumbling block because the cross of Jesus Christ demands that we die to self and we surrender to Him. The addiction mentality says, I'm at the center of my universe and everything revolves around me. And by the way, the church can get into that just as easily. I've been there. And the stumbling block is when Christ calls you to remove yourself from the center of the universe and place Him squarely in the center, and everything in your life revolves around Him. That's where some of us stumble. But when Christ calls us, as Diedrich Bonhoeffer says, He calls us to die. Amen? Brother Brent, I'm going to ask you to come up. Would you share this morning about what God has done in your life? What brought you to Teen Challenge, and where has God taken you?
I'm Bryn. I'm 31 years old, and I'm from Nashville, Tennessee. About 13 years old, I started smoking marijuana. And if anybody tells you that's not a gateway drug, that's a lie, because, yeah, I mean, it opened up the floodgates for me. It led me to pills, alcohol, cocaine, women. And then from that, you know, there's crime. You're stealing for the drugs you want. And inevitably, that leads to going to jail. And then jail leads to prison. And I was in a sermon in prison. And he was talking about how he's been clean and sober for 20 years and staying out of trouble and this and that. And I was like, man, maybe that's what I need in my life. And so I got back and I started doing Bible studies and reading the Bible and praying. And I spoke to my family and I was like, is there anything that you can do to help me be more productive, to bring me closer to God? And my brother mentioned Teen Challenge to me. And I petitioned the courts and they approved for me to come to Teen Challenge. And Teen Challenge, I've learned it's a tool that God is using to just turned me into the person that he created me to be, and it's bringing me closer to God every day. I've been baptized now, May 22nd, and I've been in the program 7 months right now. I got six to go, and it seems like a long ways, but at the same time, it's scary because I've got a lot more to learn before I get out of here. But it's done amazing things in my lives and in my fellow brothers' lives. I mean, I've watched these guys grow up and grow so strong spiritually. It's amazing. But thank you.
Tell us about the first day you walked in the Teen Challenge. What was that feeling like?
The first day I walked in, I was ready to be here. I mean, it was definitely a change. It's a lot of structure, but I mean, it's for the good. We didn't have structure in our life, and that's what got us into drugs and alcohol and the life of crime.
How would you describe your outlook on life when you came to Teen Challenge?
My outlook on life, I didn't really have any hope before I come, but now I have hope. I have a plan for when I get done, and my family's sticking by my side 100% at this point.
Amen, 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 amen. Church, that's faith. That's faith. Walk in day one without hope. Don't be deceived. It has nothing to do with the program of Teen Challenge. It has everything to do with the grace of God. Amen? 7 months later, able to stand and say, there's hope for my life now. That's faith. I can't explain how it happened. I see you most every day. I can't explain how it happened, but I believe in the God that made it happen. Amen? Would you pray with me for Brother Brent? Lord, we thank you for this life. God, I thank you for this testimony. Lord, 7 months ago, lost without hope, Lord, you've come into this life and you have filled that void. He is baptized. He is spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ. He's clean and sober, and he's got hope for his future. I thank God for that this morning. Lord, I pray that you'd continually hold him close to you. Lord, give him wisdom to hear your voice. Keep him accountable. Lord, that he would never go back to his addiction again. We ask this in the strong name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Would you give him a hand? Thank you, brother. The Apostle Paul. See it right here, all these guys. Apostle Paul's headed on that road. Rebellion, self-centeredness, fighting against God, and God got a hold of them, grabbed his attention, and turned them onto the right path. Listen to how Paul ends this section to the Corinthian church. He says this, "For the foolishness of God is wiser than man's wisdom, and the weakness of God is stronger than man's strength." Amen? I thank God for that this morning. I need that. The foolishness of God is wiser than man's wisdom, and the weakness of God is stronger than man's strength. Would you hear me this morning, church? God does not need your strengths and your talents. God is not interested in you impressing him with your ability. Teen Challenge. God is not putting gold stars on our shirts when we do good. What God looks from each of us is a heart that is surrendered to him. And when he sees that, when he sees brokenness, that's when he steps in and says, I can use that person. Amen? They're not looking for a pat on the back. I can use that person because he's broken. On the flip side, Teen Challenge, I thank God that he used your weakness. He used that moment in my life of weakness. He's used it in your life. That thing that we allowed into our life that was destructive, God turned it around, and that very addiction that was going to destroy your life was the very thing God used to save you. Amen? You had aunts, you had grandmas, you had fathers, you had mothers, you had brothers that were constantly telling you to get on the right path, and you didn't want to listen to them, but God used your addiction to get a hold of you. Your weakness to build strength into your life. He's done that for me. In church, he'll do that for you. Would you bow your heads, please? Lord, I thank you for your great grace in my life. Lord, you've taken my weaknesses, Lord God. Those things that I've allowed into my life that were meant to destroy me, Lord, through your grace, you have turned them around and used them as a teaching tool to build strength in my life. Lord, you've done it over and over again in this congregation, in the lives of these Teen Challenge men. Lord, let us never get our eyes off the cross. Lord, Paul learned it the hard way. Let us never get our eyes off the cross, but let us be focused on what you're able to do with a heart that is surrendered. I'm going to ask for our Teen Challenge men. I'm going to ask if you would join me right up at the front here, our Hope House guys, if we have any here. I'm going to ask that you would just line up right across and get an elbow length away from everyone. Pastor, if it's all right, I'm going to ask for this church if they would come up and pray with some of these individuals. Thank you. If our worship team wants to join us up front, they can. Guys, spread all the way out. We got room all the way down to the end there. We got room. Follow right back with your heels to that steps. Keep going all the way down, Brother Vincent, all the way to the end of those stairs. Amen. Spread out. I'm a good elbow length away from everyone else. Keep going all the way down. Amen. By the way, we've got other guys in our reentry program that are in different churches all across the city. So some of these guys that you see up here are not all of our guys in the program. Be praying for them as well. But I'm going to invite this church, and we've got some Spirit-led people here. As God begins to lay on your heart, would you find one of these men during this time of prayer? You can ask them their name. If they're comfortable, they'll share their story with you. Ask, how can I pray with you? Would you take a moment and pray with these men and pray that God would give them strength to make it through the program, that God would break that bondage of addiction in their life, and that God would put hope for their future? Some of these men have been here 12, 13 months. Some of these men have been here 12, 13 days. But as God lays on your heart, would you find one of these men this morning? Would you pray with them? Would you stand with me, church, and I'll invite our musicians whenever they're ready, they can begin to play. Lord, I thank you for this church that loves Teen Challenge. And I pray, use their prayers, use their encouragement in the lives of these men. Would you use it for your glory? We ask in the strong name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Even now, would you begin, every one of these guys, my prayer, somebody's with them, standing and praying with them for a moment. Would you find somebody you can pray with this morning?
Oh, to Jesus.